In previous lectures, we discussed that power converters will play an important role in microgrids. In this video, you will learn the ways in which power converters can support the grid-connected and islanded modes of operation of a microgrid. We will see that power converters can be classified into three types according to their operation. Today, we will look at each of them and discuss their main characteristics. In general, power converters can be divided into three different types: grid forming, grid feeding, and grid supporting. This last group can be divided into current source-based and voltage source-based grid supporting converters. Depending on the type, local control is implemented differently. Let's see how this is done for an AC microgrid. So let's first have a look at the grid forming type. A grid forming converter can be represented by an ideal AC voltage source with low output impedance. The main goal of a grid-forming converter is to form a stable grid with constant voltage and frequency. For this reason, these converters can only operate in islanded mode, where voltage and frequency is determined by them. In order to operate in parallel with other grid-forming converters, they require an external synchronization signal provided by the microgrid central controller. A practical example of this is the standby uninterruptible power source. So let's now have a look at the second type, the grid feeding power converter. These converters can be represented by a grid connected ideal current source with a high impedance in parallel. Grid feeding converters adjust the set points of the active and reactive power according to the input power source. Unlike the grid forming converter, the grid feeding type can be operated in both grid-connected and islanded modes. The outer loop controls the levels of active and reactive power, as shown in the figure on the right-hand side, and the inner loop controls the current of such inverters. Finally, the required voltage is applied typically through a modulator, which features modulation techniques such as pulse width modulation. As already mentioned, grid-supporting power converters can be divided into current source-based and voltage source-based converters. Grid-supporting converters are placed in between a grid-feeding and a grid-forming power converter, and their main objective is to deliver power values of active and reactive power to contribute to the regulation of the grid frequency and voltage. For example, a current source-based converter can deliver the active and reactive power set points to a distributed generator connected to the microgrid. As in the case of the grid feeding type, these converters can operate during both islanded and grid connected modes. The voltage source based converter can be represented as a non-ideal voltage source that primarily controls both the voltage and the frequency of the microgrid. In such a scheme, voltage and frequency set points are determined according to the reactive and active power set points, respectively. Also, these converters can operate both during islanded and grid connected modes. So to sum up, let's now take a look again at the characteristics of the three types of converters. The grid forming type is represented by an ideal voltage source, and its control is based on a constant frequency and voltage strategy. The output frequency is a fixed frequency. This means that the frequency is given by the converter and not imposed by the grid. The main application of this type of converters is islanded mode. In case of the grid feeding converter, the source can be represented as an ideal current source, and its control is based on both active and reactive power. Unlike the grid forming type, the grid feeding converter shows an output frequency that is synchronized with the grid. Finally, the grid supporting converters can be divided into current source based and voltage source based. They contribute to the regulation of the grid and can be used for both grid-connected and islanded modes of operation. In the next videos, we will see how trip control is implemented in microgrids through these converters.